In this video, I am going to talk about different ways how you can lower prolactins naturally. So let's first know what is prolactin. It is a hormone released from the pituitary gland and its function is to promote milk production in the breast so that the mother can nurse her baby. A way to remember the definition is that pro mean to produce and lactin means lactation or milk. Prolactin production is restricted by dopamine, which is a hormone released from the hypothalamus. So dopamine release will decrease prolactin secretion. Prolactin level should be high during late pregnancy and during breastfeeding, though it is possible for prolactin level to be high when you are not pregnant or breastfeeding, which can cause complications. Infertility, PCOS, and irregular periods are all symptoms of having high prolactin levels while not breastfeeding or enduring pregnancy. Prolactin interferes with ovulation, and no ovulation means no period, which explains the irregular cycles and infertility. Some factors only raise prolactin slightly while others can raise it more dramatically. So what are some ways to lower prolactin naturally? Let's get into the video. Balancing blood sugar. Balancing blood sugar is a good way to lower prolactin naturally. Studies have found that glucose insensitivity causes high prolactin level due to higher fatty acid levels, increased insulin receptors, or complications with insulin binding. This can show that by balancing blood sugar, you can lower prolactins naturally. Removing beer and barley from your diet. Another way to lower prolactin naturally is to remove barley and beer from your lifestyle. Both beer and barley are high in gluten, a protein which is present in wheat, rye, and barley products. Gluten may exacerbate the high prolactin levels if you are slightly gluten sensitive. This is shown in a study where participants drank 0.5 gram per kg body weight of alcohol, and the results expressed a rise in prolactin level. This effect can be due to acute changes in dopamine levels in the hypothalamus. Another way is to manage stress. Managing stress can be another way to lower prolactin levels naturally. When we are stressed, we release high levels of cortisol, a stress hormone. In response to this, our body is trying to survive given threatening circumstances. So, the body will adapt to combat the stress by initiating many other functions. In this case, it has been shown that high levels of prolactin are released to try and gain homeostasis under high stress situations. The immune system slows down in response to stress, but prolactin has regulatory effects to help improve the immune system. Additionally, a study found that females who were exposed to childhood trauma are more likely to have prolactin in later life. Ways to manage stress include getting more sound sleep at night, eating balanced meals, medication, mindful movement, and gentle exercise. Another way to lower prolactin is to avoid undereating. This is beneficial because undereating can cause stress on the body due to unbalanced sugar and increased cortisol. A study showed that women who were eating a negative energy balance had increased prolactin levels. This shows that if you avoid undereating, you can lower prolactin naturally. Vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 is a water-soluble vitamin that can actually lower prolactin, and vitamin B6 has a mechanism that will inhibit the prolactin production by increasing the dopaminergic effect in the hypothalamus, because we know that dopamine and prolactin oppose each other. Another way is to make sure that you do not have a pituitary tumor to lower prolactin. Prolactinoma is when a non-cancerous tumor forms in the pituitary gland in the brain, and it causes high production of prolactin. Symptoms that come with prolactinoma are vaginal dryness, irregular periods, discharge from nipples, and low sexual arousal. You can avoid a lot of confusion by ruling out if you have a pituitary tumor. Diagnosis is done by an MRI through your doctor and will need some medications to manage it. The tumor can be removed, and this will help to lower the prolactin levels. Another way is to check your kidney and liver levels. Prolactin levels are elevated in those with chronic kidney disease. Chronic kidney disease is signaled by the poor functioning of kidneys, which help to detoxify the blood. Those who have kidney disease can be at a risk for cardiovascular diseases, and high prolactin levels can accelerate this process. Prolactin levels tend to rise in patients with kidney disease, mainly through the medications taken to regulate the disease. A study found that most of the patients with high prolactin were taking medication to make the levels higher. So, regulating the medication can help to lower the prolactin level naturally. The same goes for liver. The liver is responsible for detoxification, metabolism, and it secretes bile. It has been found that patients with liver disease have increased prolactin levels. Alcohol abuse is one of the main causes of liver disease, and a correlation could be that the effect can be due to acute changes in dopamine levels in the hypothalamus. So by checking your liver, you can possibly lower the prolactin levels. Lastly, checking your thyroid can help to lower the prolactin's level naturally. Many studies have shown that females who have high prolactin may have a form of thyroid disease. In this case, a thyroid disease limits the number of thyroid hormones produced. This low production of the thyroid hormone can be what causes high prolactin. The reason for this is because there can be structural changes in the follicles of the thyroid which result in high production of prolactin hormone. Therefore, it can inhibit the action of other sex hormones, which causes infertility. Additionally, the study found that by supplementing the thyroid hormones, prolactin levels can be restored to normal. This is why checking your thyroid can also help you to lower your prolactin levels. So that was all about in this video. I hope you found this useful, and thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to share.